Okay, fine.
Now, if you see in last session, we spoke about what is container, what is component, right? Now, today I will make you comfortable in writing your EJBs. Okay, that's what is my objective, to help you practically implementing EJBs, right? But before we start, I will like to tell you what actually EJB is and in what way EJB is going to help us out in building our business logic. Okay, fine.
Okay.
Now, just take up a simple you say problem and simple case and try to identify the problem with that. Okay. Now, assume that you have written this code. For example, you have written product test, right? And assume that this is a function in that, right? For example, let me write here a function public void validate card. Okay, this is what is the function, fine. Now, this validate card function will be called by thousands of users, right?
Yeah.
Because when we talk about shopping cart, many people will be shopping at the same time and many financial transactions will start at the same time, right? So, it means that this test class probably have to serve hundreds and thousands of users, right?
Okay.
Okay. Now, what happens for each user? Assume that one object is getting created. What will be the problem? What will be the problem? Out of memory, right? Hello?
Yeah.
Out of memory, because thousands of users mean thousands of objects. Each object will occupy some memory. So, at some or other point of time, you will find that your entire memory is occupied by these objects.
Okay, yeah.
So, capacity planning becomes very difficult. So, what can be done here? What we can do is we can adopt an approach where only few objects will cater hundreds and thousands of clients. Okay. It means it will not create thousands of instances. It will just create few instances, and those few instances will be used by current users who are trying to validate their card.
Okay. Okay.
So, someone should be there who should take responsibility of deciding how many instances need to be created, when an instance need to be destroyed, when a new instance need to be created, which instance should be given to which client, when actually the client has released that instance so that it can be given to other client, right? So, all these housekeeping tasks of managing instances need to be done by someone. Who does that? Container, right? It means now I have to implement my business logic and I have to write business logic following specifications so that my container can manage that particular business logic and he can decide how many instances need to be created. Okay, right. So, when you go and if you want to adopt this approach, your Sun Microsystem provided this capability by giving you EJBs, Enterprise Java Beans, where now your Java Bean will contain logic, but it will be managed by container. Okay, is it clear?
Yeah.
So, now if someone is asking you what is Enterprise Java Bean, it's very simple, contains business logic, right? Bean lifecycle is managed by container, right? It you can go and configure your container to so that it can control your logic in the way you want. For example, you are not satisfied with default feature of containers transaction management. So, you will like to tell container, right, I do not want this policy of transaction management, please go ahead with this policy, right. So, all that can be externalized, that is what we call it as externalized configuration, which decouples configuration from your business logic, right. Client access mediated by container, it means whatever client wants to do, it will be mediated by container. And this container supports transaction and security. Okay, the enterprise beans are special business logic which are written following EJB specifications. They are managed by containers. Configurations can be externalized, and which instance need to be allocated to whom will be mediated by the container. And container is well aware about transactions and security. It means I can write my code, my business logic, which has transactional and security capability. Is that clear?
Yeah, okay.
Good. Now, if you see how many types of EJBs are there, See, earlier in previous versions like TJB 2.1 and all, you used to have three different type of TJBs. One is session bean, second is entity bean, and third is message driven bean. Okay, but with TJB 3.0 recent version, they said container will not manage persistence. Let persistence be managed by ORMs like Hibernate. We have seen Hibernate in our first session, right? Demo session.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Right. So persistence management container said I will not manage. I will just have two types of TJBs now. One is session bean and second is message bean. Okay.
Sure.
Now, as of now, we will focus on session beans. Right.
Okay.
Session beans are of you say three types with TJB 3.1. Now please understand, we are going through recent version of TJB. First one is stateful session bean, second is stateless session bean, and third is singleton session bean. Okay. So mm-hmm. someone is asking, okay, tell me in TJB 3.1 or JEE 6, how many types of session beans you have? Three: stateful, stateless, and singleton. Right. Now,
okay,
what is this stateless session bean? See, stateless session bean is a bean which will say I will not remember any client. I am not going to store any data which is specific to any client. Okay. But when mm-hmm. I say stateful session bean, what it means? It will retain client specific data. For example, if I am accessing an stateful session bean, that session bean will be dedicated to me. Why? Because it holds my information, right?
Okay.
So if three clients are trying to access stateful session bean, how many instances will be allocated? Three, right?
Three. Okay. Mm-hmm.
Why three? Because each client will have his own instance.
Mm-hmm.
Right?
Okay.
They
mm-hmm.
are storing client specific information there. Right? But
mm-hmm.
when I say stateless session bean, same instance can serve multiple clients, right?
Okay.
Why? Because that instance is not bothered about mm-hmm. who is accessing it.
Okay.
So once a client accesses, task is over, that same instance can be allocated to others also. Right.
Okay.
This is what is called as stateless session bean. Right.
Mm-hmm.
Is that clear?
Yeah.
So sometimes you will like to have only one instance of bean, not more than one. So you have to ask your container that, see, I don't want you to create more than one instance. I want you to create only one instance of this particular bean. That type of session bean is called as what? Singleton bean. Okay. If someone is asking you, tell me.
That happens in the stateless session beans, right? It will hold
the. No, but it can create in stateless session bean. It can create more than one instance. If it feels that one instance is not sufficient enough to cater hundreds of clients, it will go and create new instances. But when we say singleton, it will not create more than one instance irrespective of how many clients are trying to access it.
Okay, okay, fine. Okay.
Okay. So this is how actually you will be talking about stateless. So one liner is what you need to remember. Stateful retains client information. One instance per client. Stateless is not bothered about client info. Same instance can be used by multiple clients. Singleton,
there's one
at
one
any point of time you will have only one instance.
Not more
okay?
than one instance. Okay.
Right. So these three things are there that you need to remember. Is that clear?
Yeah.
Now if you see how frustrated this developer is, who is building everything from ground, where he is taking care of transaction management, multi-threading, security, networking. And you see this developer who is using application server, I mean to say container, how cool he is, right? Because he need to just focus on business server. Rest everything is managed by whom? By your container. Yeah, by your server. Okay. Is that clear? Fine. Now, without wasting much of time, let's go and create a session bean and see how we can make call to that session bean from a client. Client here I will take is servlet. In previous session I have shown you how to create an enterprise application, right? So I am going to create it again so that you can look at it again, right? What is an enterprise application? I told you in previous session, one enterprise application can have multiple components, right? Multiple mm-hmm. web components, multiple EKG components, all that we have seen, right?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so we'll go and we'll create. I'll go to Java EE perspective so that I can get all the tools, and now I will ensure that I have server added here and my server gets started. So let me go and start the server. पूरा रिकॉर्ड हो जाएगा तुम्हारा। ओके सो सर्वर हैज स्टार्टेड, लेट्स सी। इट्स स्टार्टिंग। हैव यू प्रिपेयर्ड योर सिस्टम? Have you added the plugins which I told you?
Yeah, I tried. Can you check whether it is
okay, let me complete this exercise then I will check your system.
Yeah, okay. Okay.
Now let's go and create an enterprise application. I'll just close all and try to go through session immediately as soon as it is uploaded on the video. Okay.
Mm-hmm.
Right now this work is done. I'll just go and create an enterprise app. File, new enterprise application project. Okay.
Okay.
Give a name. I'll write here project one. Right. Ensure that EAR version is 6.0 because we are going through the recent one.
Mm-hmm.
Click on next. Now you see, I'll click on new module and I will take web module and EJB module, where web module will be my client to EJBs. Okay, where I will write a servlet who will invoke the EJBs. Okay.
Mm-hmm.
I'll be taking up servlets also in greater detail, but I want you to work with EJBs first and come up with lots of doubts. We're creating an EJB module. Now as I told you that always better to have application.xml because I can open this file and I can see how many modules are there as of now. Okay. I've shown you in last session as well.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Okay. Now we have project. Let me show you application.xml once again because probably you might have missed it because video was not there. I'll just go. Source, you see one web module and one EJB module, right?
Yeah.
Fine. Now let's go and create our first EJB. See how simple it is. I'll select EJB module, right click, new. I'll go and select what? Session bin, because we want to create session bin. Always package it on dot beans. Right, give a name to the class. I'll write here, for example, say banking service beans. Right, you have to select type. If you see how many types are there here in state type,
mm-hmm.
stateless, stateful, and
singleton.
Right, so I'll select stateless. Now it is asking you that what all interfaces I should create. Interfaces for whom? For client, right? Client need to know what all are the methods which are there in your banking service bean, right? So what you will give to the clients? You will give interfaces. Now here there are two types of interfaces. One is local, second is remote, right?
Mm-hmm.
Now what is meaning of local? Local means your client, your EJBs are being accessed by client from the same JVM instance. Okay. That means your web module as well as your EJB module are part of the same project, right?
Okay.
Is that clear?
No, I didn't get this model.
Yeah. So what is local is clear? When client is present where? In the same JVM instance, right?
Okay. Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Feedback.
And what is remote? When you try to access an EJB from a external JVM. For example, I have my server in which I have the EJB. You have a server in which you have web component. Now you want to access web EJB from an external web component, right? So what type of interface is required?
Remote.
Good, right? So I will select both because I want to provide access to remote as well as local.
Okay.
So I go and click on next. Now you see what artifact it creates. It creates banking service remote, banking service with an implementation class, right? Now transaction type, I want my container to manage transactions. So I have selected here
container.
Click on finish. Right, now you see, you got it here, right?
Yeah.
Is it clear?
Yeah.
Now you go and see what all it has created. It has created one local interface, it has created one remote interface, and it has created the implementation class. Right?
Okay.
Fine. Now see how I will come to know that which one is implementation class. See, at the rate stateless, right? So on top of this class, you have used an annotation called as stateless. How I will come to know that this interface is local? At the rate local. How I will come to know that this interface is remote? At the rate remote. So how many annotations we have used in order to build a stateless SLB? Three, right? Stateless, local, and remote. Okay.
Okay.
Is that clear?
Yeah.
So we just use three interfaces, three annotations. Now I will go and write method. Okay, fine. Public void this bank details. This is an interface, and you know in Java interfaces cannot have implemented methods. Okay.
Yeah.
So this method is there in my remote. Same method I will write in local also. It means my local client and remote client both can access what method? This bank details, whose implementation I will do here, right? I just go here, add unimplemented method. Here I will write this out. Whatever logic is there, right? As of now, I am not concerned about this logic. I am more concerned about you understanding the artifacts which are needed in order to go and build your session base. Okay. I'll write here Bank of America. Right? Something. I'll click on save. Right? So the minute I clicked on save, all errors are gone. Our EJB is ready. Simple, right? Is that simple?
Yeah.
Okay, you have to go through video once again in order to initially you will face some you'll be uncomfortable, but I'm sure that after you understand how we created and all, you will be able to do it fast. Okay.
Okay.
You want me to do it again? Or it's fine, we'll go through video.
Please.
It's fine, right?
Hello?
Okay, let's complete the cycle and then I'll ask you again if required. I will definitely help you out. Okay.
Okay.
Fine. My EJB is ready. Now, how to put this EJB or this project in the container? You see, our container is provided by JBoss, right? For that, what I am doing, you see, select the project, right click, run as. Please be careful with some errors which may come because they are important to understand. You may get this error in production as well. I'll just go and click on next. I'm saying that please place this project one in the server. I'll go and click on finish. Now the minute I do this, you see here, your project one comes here, and you get error. Okay, let's see this error. Be careful because this is a very prominent error. It is saying unexpected error because unsupported class version. Whenever you get this error, you should understand that your compiler is of different version and your interpreter is of different version. Okay.
Okay.
Is that clear? So I'll just go and see how I will change it. I'll go to properties. You have to be careful when you are doing it. Project facets. You see here, it's ER6. This is fine. Now I will go to EJB. Right click, properties. And you see here, Java is 1.7. I'll go and change it to 1.6 because I'm using 1.6 for my server.
Okay.
I'll go to compiler, and I'll say please use compliance level as 1.6. You got it right? You got why we are changing this? Because my compiler and my server have different versions of Java, so I'm just going to make it compatible. It will say rebuild. Yes, please go ahead and rebuild. Okay. Okay. Now same thing I have to do with my web project also. See, I'll just go here, properties. I'll go to Java compiler. Here it is 1.7, right? I'll change it to 1.6. I'll go to project facets. Here it is 1.7. I will change it to 1.6. Now hopefully everything is fine. I'll click on OK. I'll go and place my request to server once again. I'll say, please go and full publish. Right? And I'll see the console now. You have to wait for some message which I will tell you. Are you able to see these messages?
Yeah.
This message. You are able to see, right?
Yeah.
It says what? Started EJB. Okay. It means now you have placed your component in the container. Okay.
Okay.
Right. Now question comes how to access it. Right? I will go to my project one web because I will make my client here. New servlet. Com dot web, and I'll write here class name as invoke EJB. Be careful here also because we have to do two things for project settings. Next, I'll just take do get. I'll not take do post. Click on finish. Now my objective is to go and access EJB, right?
Yeah.
For this, what I will do, you see. I have to pass, I'll select project properties. Now all these are settings that you have to do. Java build path projects. Are you able to see EJB module here? No, right?
No.
And you want your web module to use EJB module, right? I'll go and select project one EJB. Now are you able to see project one EJB?
Yeah.
It means you have set the reference of your web module in. Of your EJB module in your web module, okay? Click on OK. Last step. You have to inject. You see how we'll inject. I'll write here @ annotation EJB. I'll select here E, control space bar, EJB. Right, and I want to use here local interface. So I use what? Banking, bean local, and I'll say local. Right. So you have done injection. You have made this EJB reference available here. I'll just go here and write one system. Let me write here the code. Response dot set content type to tell that you want content in what type. I want it in HTML. Okay, I'm just specifying it. Text/HTML. Response dot get writer so that you can write something on the response object dot. I'm just writing print ln. Right. AJB part. If any problem will be there in calling the AJB, it will throw a circle. And here I am making call to local dot this blank bank details. It's clear. So how many lines of code we have written? If you see, hardly two lines. One is we have injected. We have injected the EJB local interface, and then we have made call to the methods. Okay.
Mm-hmm.
If you want to inject remote, what you have to do instead of local, you'll specify here remote. Okay. Yeah.
Okay.
So now your EJB is ready. Your client is ready. Let's go and run it. Before running, one thing you have to do. Whenever you are making changes to your code, right? You have to go and run on the server. And sometimes you have to restart the server. So I'll go and restart the server here. Why we will restart? Because some changes are there which are available only after you restart.
Okay.
I'll just go here and start the server. Right now next task is just to go and run. I will run what? Servlet, right? What is name of the servlet? What is the name of the servlet we have written just now? Invoke EJB, right?
Okay.
Here it is, invoke EJB. I'll just go and write here, invoke
EJB.
Press enter. What it says? EJB called, and here what it is displaying?
Bank of America.
Now this logic is written where? Here, right?
Mm-hmm.
So can you tell me now how many annotations are there which we have to use? 4 annotations, right? As of now, my objective is you should understand those annotations. What is first one? At the rate, state here. Second one.
Local.
To specify that this interface is local, and remote. Third one to specify that this interface remote. Is remote. And what annotation you will use in client wherever you want to invoke?
At the rate.
And here what you have to specify the interface which you want to use, right?
Okay.
As of now we want to use local, so I have specified here local.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
Is that fine?
Yeah.
This is how you will be creating the EJB. Area of concern here is I have used Eclipse in order to get everything done, right? I want mm-hmm. you to focus on this, go through the video, and at least okay. be comfortable in this, right?
Okay.
Rest you will understand. You don't worry about concepts and implementation, practical logic, all that I will tell you. You need to just focus on how I am effectively using Eclipse. Okay?
Okay.
I'll make you the presenter. You can share your desktop. So that we can see and configure your Eclipse also similar to mine. Okay.
Okay.
So I'll make you the presenter now. Now you are the presenter. You just share your desktop. Just share your desktop.
It shows me that you are already sharing an application, a browser. You can perform only one activity at a time.
It's the same thing which you got last time, right?
Yeah, right.
But later you are able to share, I think, no? Yeah, now I'm getting. I got, but again it went off.
Can you see my desktop?
No, I cannot.
Oh, it's over there.
You have TeamViewer?
Yeah. Yeah, we can do it in Team.
Okay.
Yeah, I'll share it.
TeamViewer is what I will. You have to just send me your user ID and password of TeamViewer.
Yeah, sure. It's user ID is 325.
Okay, just wait. No, I'll.
Okay.
I'll let you know when I want. Yeah, can you tell me your ID?
3 2 5 4 6 5 4 6 5 4 5 3 4 5 3 1 6
Yeah.
Yeah,
tell me the password. 5 2 2 3 5 2 2 3
Yeah.
Okay, it's connecting now. Fine. So launch your Eclipse now. I'm able to see your desktop. I'm able to see so many. Yeah, just go to this, right? Go to window. You say yes.
Okay.
Okay. Now go to yes. You see whether you are getting Hibernate or not here? Hello?
Yeah, hello.
Hello? हेलो
हेलो
सेशन हो एक काम करते हैं ना रात में चलते हैं क्योंकि आज जो उसको भी बिठाना है ना अपने को और दो तीन घंटा काम है उससे पूरा उसका वो लेना है भाई 9 बजे हाँ ठीक है ठीक ओके इट्स नॉट देयर राइट क्लिक ऑन कैंसिल
सॉरी क्लिक ऑन
Cancel, cancel.
Okay.
Yeah. Now you go to select your invoice generation project which you have written. Right click.
राइट क्लिक, गो टू न्यू, गो टू अदर्स, now you don't have hibernate here also, just go and see. No, you don't have, cancel it. Now you go to help. In help, go to Eclipse Marketplace. Yeah, in search you write JBoss Tools. Yes. Now what you have to do is just select Kepler, JBoss Tool. JBoss Tool. Don't write Hibernate Tool. Write JBoss Tools.
JBoss.
Because we have to download everything at the same time. Okay. Now Kepler. You select Kepler. You have already selected it.
Yeah.
I don't know what all you have installed, because it's not showing anything installed. Okay. Just go to Juno and click on install.
Juno. Okay.
Now unselect all from here. Top one. Yes. Now go to Hibernate Tools. Select Hibernate Tools. Now whatever selections we have made, right? You have to. JBoss Tool AS. Yes, JBoss AS Tools, JMX Console.
Confirm, right?
As of now, yeah, JMX Console.
Oh.
Okay, fine. Click on OK. Select JMX Console and confirm. This is show details. Click on detail.
There is nothing to update.
Click on OK. After click on cancel. After doing installation, have you restarted your Eclipse? And you restarted, right?
Yeah, I did, I think.
Go to file, new. Go to
enterprise.
Yeah, enterprise application project. But you don't have the server also. Okay, cancel it. Now go to window, preferences, select preferences. Okay. Now in this you go to servers, expand the servers. Now go to runtime environments. Click on add. Now go to JBoss. Down, go to JBoss enterprise middleware. Yeah, select JBoss enterprise application platform 6.0. Okay, click on next. Oh wait, click on download and install. So what this will do, it will download and it will install your version. Select the version, first one. Click on next. Accept the license. Click on next. Right, click on finish. So it is only there for manual download. Okay, click on back and go to JBoss community. select JBoss 6.x. Click on next. Go back. Let me take 7y6. Select 7.0. Click on next. Click on download and install. Select first version and click on next. Accept the license. Next. And then go and click on finish. Now see, it will download it. It is downloading it, right?
Yeah.
It will download and it will install it.
Mm-hmm.
So as a developer, this is the way how you can get runtime. For WAS, for WebLogic, for JBoss. I'm getting echo. Okay, now host directory does not exist. Home directory is not at this place, Tani. You just go click on browse where it has got installed, you have to find out. Go and click on your folder. Yeah, just go and see down where it has installed. Yeah, here it is, JBoss 7AS. Select that, yes. Click on OK. So this is the home directory where your server is installed.
Okay.
Click on finish. Click on okay, you have JDK, what? Just double click on this, right? Okay, double click on that.
Yeah, I want this.
Okay. Click on OK. Now if you see JBoss 7 is there, just select it and right click start. Before starting JBoss, you have to see that Tomcat is stopped. It is stopped, fine. So you go and start it. Now go and see the servers. It is started, right?
Yeah.
Now go and create an enterprise file. New enterprise application project. Write there project 1. And see, be careful, target runtime is there, right? Just click on the combo. You see JBoss runtime, first one you add. Yes. If you will not add this, your project will not get the directories. Okay. Jar files and all. Now go and click on next. Ensure that you have selected generate application.xml.
Okay.
Click on finish. Here also you can click new module. Okay, fine. If you have not created, that also fine. Right. Now assume that we created enterprise project, but we have not added new modules. Right? How to do that? How to add new module? Go to file. Click on new. Select EJB project.
राइट हियर नाउ नेम ऑफ द प्रोजेक्ट, मुझे प्रोजेक्ट वन ही दे दी. Don't give space. Never you should change spaces. Right? Now, you see target runtime is fine. EJB module is fine. Now, you see EAR membership. It is saying, right? Add project to EAR. Select that. Now, this module will automatically get added to this EAR project. Click on next. Right? And create EJB client project unselected. We don't need it because we will be writing our own client, right? Click on finish. Click on finish. Now you see you have go to application.xml. Go to project one. Expand it. ER content expand it. Go to meta INF. Open application.xml. Are you able to see module project one EJB sir? Now we have to add one web component
web
now.
Okay.
So web module. Go to file, new, select dynamic web project. File, new, dynamic web project.
Okay.
Yes. Now give a name, project one web. Right. Come and select add project to EAR. Click on next. Click on next and finish. So now you have what? Go and see. It has added again, right? Is that fine?
Yeah.
Now we want to create EJBs. Let's go to your EJB project. Project one EJB. Expand it. Expand it. Yeah. Go to EJB module. Right click.
Okay.
New. Session beam.
Okay.
Now you can give a package name com dot something.
Com dot.
Com dot whatever you want, like com dot beam. Now come to class name and right here customer service beam. Customer service deal, because this is the business logic, right? And whenever you are changing word, word should be capital, like S should be capital. Follow the convention.
Service.
Bean. Again, bean. B capital. Right. Now, fine. Now, state type. You want stateless or stateful? Just go and expand the combo box. To see, yes. We want stateless. We'll select stateless. Now, which type of interface you want? Local, remote, select both, and unselect this no interface view.
It's already selected.
I'll tell you this also later. Yeah, unselect this no interface view.
Oh.
Go back. Yes. Next. Now, if you see here, transaction type is container because we don't want to manage transaction. Click on finish. Right, if you see your artifacts gets generated, right? At the rate stateless. Now go and see service beam local, service beam remote. No message are there because we have not written anything, right?
Okay.
Is that fine?
Yeah. Okay.
Right. So now you have to write logic and you have to implement it. I feel that you are comfortable now in creating an enterprise project and these modules?
Yeah, it's a little bit okay now.
Okay. So what I'll do, I will leave you here itself. I'll ask Anthony to upload the video as soon as possible, right?
Okay.
So that you can implement the logic as well. So I feel by the time we meet tomorrow, you will be comfortable in working with IT. As I told you, I'm not bothered as of now about with logic or how to implement and all. I want you to be good in using Eclipse in order to create these enterprise articles.
Okay.
Fine. So you can, I think it's too late for you now. You can sleep and I'll ask him to go and upload the video.
Yeah, okay.
Okay, and I'll share the material also with you because now we have logic.
Yeah, okay, Inajay.
Okay, okay.
Yeah, thank you.
I feel that you are thinking it is too heavy, but don't worry. This is what you will be doing in companies, right? So I just can't give you simple things.
Okay, then. Yeah.
Okay, okay.
Yeah,
okay,
thank you.